Checking document accessibility. Quick tips for Microsoft Word. An NCRTM video cast developed by New Editions Consulting, Inc.
This is the video for how to check your Word document for accessibility. You may be wondering, how do I know if my Word document is accessible? There are several easy steps you can do to check your document without any additional tools needed other than Word itself. As a reminder, Microsoft Office has made it easy for you to make fairly accessible documents by using their templates and built-in styling and formatting, like lists, tables, and headings. For more on how to develop accessible Word documents, please see the videos on how to create accessible Word documents. Word's built-in accessibility checker is the easiest and fastest tool to give you an overview of possible problems within your document. To run the accessibility checker, save your document, open File, check for issues, then check accessibility. The checker also lists exactly where each item occurs and when each line item is selected. Additional information is displayed explaining why you should fix the issue and how to fix it. For more information, please view the remediation video on Word documents. The checker will display errors, warnings, and tips. You will want to pay most attention to the errors. We have adapted the following information from a group of accessibility experts within the government for this demonstration. Several of the most important items to check for are: number one, headings; number two, lists; number three, tables; number four, images; and number five, color use to convey meaning. We'll go through each of these and point out some tips for how to check your Word document. The first one is headings. Headings help users navigate. The accessibility checker will alert you to the use of, or lack thereof, headings by an error of unstructured document. We don't have that here, but with headings, you should always verify the structure of the headings, even if the accessibility checker does or does not give you an error. You can easily check your headings by using the navigation pane. Think of it more like an outline of your document that allows the reader to skip to important parts. To enable the navigation pane, open View on your toolbar, then check the navigation pane checkbox under Show. Headings will display, and you can easily check that the headings in the navigation pane mirror the headings in the document. In this example, they do. And headings in the navigation pane match the document's visual outline. In this example, they do as well. The checker may suggest that infrequent headings are used or headings are simply too long. This is okay and can be ignored as long as the headings match the document's visual outline. The second item to check are lists. Lists help users understand content in its hierarchical association. The accessibility checker will not come in handy here, but this is where using built-in bullets and numbering will easily assist. Check that for each list, such as example 1 and example 2, which I'll get to in a minute, that the list option is visible and selected under bullets and numbering. If I highlight the first list, I can look up on the toolbar and see that the bullets is selected. This means that this list is programmatically coded as a list. If I go down to example 2, and I've told you this list is not accessible, if I highlight it, I do not see anything up on the bullets and numbering, which means this list is not programmatically associated as a list. Number 3, tables. The accessibility checker will check that your tables are in a simple format, have a defined header row, and do not have blank table cells. Check that the table was created using Word's table tool and is not a picture of a table. If the table, when selected, does not trigger a table tools tab on the toolbar, the table was created some other way and should be remediated. Selecting the first table shows that my table tools does show up in the toolbar, which means this table was created using the table tools. If I select the second one, you do not see the table tools show up, which means this table is created some sort of other way and should be fixed. Second, verify each table is free of merged or split cells. The accessibility checker will show an error if there are any merged or split cells. You can also visually look at the table and verify it has one row of columns and one header row, and no cells are merged or split across several columns. If I run the checker again, we'll see that there are no errors or warnings related to split or merged cells, so these tables are okay. The third is the accessibility checker will alert you if a header row is not defined. You can also manually check that each table has a defined header. Here we do not see an issue with the accessibility checker, but let's go manually check as well. To manually check, highlight the header row within the table. Then within the Tools tab, select Layout and ensure that the Repeat Header Row button is selected. The accessibility checker will throw an alert if there are blank table cells. This can be ignored as it will not pose any direct accessibility threat. The fourth item to check are images. Each image should have a descriptive text associated with it so that users who cannot see the image understand the information that it is conveying. Check that each image or object has either alternative text or is described within the document text. If the image is decorative, i.e. offers no value except for aesthetics, the alternative should be what we call null or a space between two quotation marks. The accessibility checker will alert you if any images or graphics have issues with alternative text. While the checker can tell you if images do not have any alternative text, it cannot tell you if the alternative text is correct. Therefore, each image should be checked individually to ensure that it has alternative text and that it is an accurate representation of the graphic, or perhaps the graphic is explained within the document content itself. Here, let's just quickly take a look and see if these images have proper alternative text. To check the alternative text, select the image, right-click, and open Format Picture. Then select Layout and Properties, and then Alt Text. Alternative text should be in this description box. Here we see the first image has an alternative text of four small turbines in a field, which is correct. Let's take a look at the second image and see what that alternative text looks like. Right-click, open Format Picture, Layout and Properties, and you can see that the description is blank, which means there is no alternative text. For redundant information and repetitive headers and footers or graphics and call-out boxes that are not meaningful, information should not be in line with text. In line with text will be a accessibility checker warning if it exists. Assistive technology will ignore objects which are not in line with text. While the accessibility checker will warn you that content is not in line, it should be verified that it's not essential for a reader. In this example, we have a call-out box with some redundant text of wind turbines. Let's see what the accessibility checker says for this. It warns that there are several objects not in line, one of them being this text box. In this example, a redundant text box is showing a warning that it's not in line, which is okay. We've already discussed that there is an alternative text for the wind turbines. This is simply a call-out box the developer thought would look pretty. Last, number five, is color use to convey meaning. Here you're going to check that the meaning of color is duplicated in text. This is a visual test, as no checker will alert you to this. Check that if color is used to convey meaning, prompt a response, or indicate an action, e.g. all required fills are red, or Peter's sails are shown in green and John's are shown in blue, that there is another textual representation of that information, just to make sure that every user can access the same information, whether or not they can see color. In this example, you see that the pie chart showing weekly sales for Mary, John, and Peter do use color to convey which slice of pie is whose, but there's also text on screen showing that Mary's 20%, she also happens to be purple, Peter's 55% happens to be blue, and John's 25% happens to be green. Here you see that while color is used, there's also text labels on the pie chart. Below is another example of all required form fields in red. They also happen to be marked with an asterisk, so someone who can't see color would know the asterisk means this is required. The last example here shows color used to convey meaning that isn't accessible. And you simply see a pie chart with three slices of a pie, no text labels, and for someone who can't see color, or if this was in, let's say, grayscale, they wouldn't know whose sales this slice of pie relates to. This is a quick video to show you the five tips on how you can check your Word document for accessibility using just the built-in tools in Word. For additional help, feel free to contact the NCRTM support team. They're always happy to help. You can contact them at ncrtm@newadditions.net.